Good evening, my fellow scientists. It is Sunday, September 23rd, 2018, and I want to talk about a project I've been working on for almost 2 years, just kind of in behind the scenes here. So last year I was vlogging every day, but I didn't really talk about this particular project because I felt like it was weird enough that maybe it didn't belong. But there's this product, and I don't want to give the manufacturer a shout out because it's really expensive and it's really technical. But it's this blue liquid. It's a slurry of a capture resin. It's blue because it has nickel in it, and it captures certain specific proteins out of a mixture of many different kinds of protein. And so for a year and a half, I've been trying to kind of replicate that. And finally, today, I have a decent replication. So we've had the chemistry for almost a year, but getting the particulate matter to be just right has taken an amazing number of replications and trial and error. And it's been kind of a nightmare. But but it works now. We can make this blue slurry ourselves. So if you're curious, our goal all this time has been to make this molecule, where this block over here is a polymer that supports this molecule over here, which looks nicely symmetrical and is actually a chelator that holds nickel. So if you put nickel into this polymer, it's kind of a gel-like substance. The nickel stays there, but more importantly, anything else that likes nickel, such as histidine tags proteins, will stick to this polymer really effectively, and we can purify it by that interaction. The funny thing is, it all started with Reddit. So I was asking around about whether we can make this stuff ourselves, whether we can make it cheaply. It's this nickel-nitrilotriacetic acid resin. Can you make it cheaply in the lab? And no, the answer is no, you can't. So generally speaking, if you're going to try to make it, you're going to make it out of little crumbs of agarose, and they're going to have to be activated with cyanogen bromide, which no one wants to use ever. I certainly don't want it in my lab. So it's a nasty process. It's not cheap. It's not easy. And it should be. There should be a way to make this cheaply and easily. And since then, I've really tried to back off on the whole cheap and easy project, because they never are. But after, you know, a year and a half, we finally have a relatively easy and modestly cheap process to make this material. So I can finally go back to that Reddit thread and reply, yeah, it's totally possible to make this stuff yourself. And maybe we can publish it. So anyway, that's what science is for me. A long process of trial and error, of really difficult stuff, to do something cheap and easy.